can see. In Linux, you there are some dependencies like Apache, PHP, library, GCC, and these have a different supportive dependency, and they have a different meaning. If you are not installed over there, there might be causes some problem while execute any commands. So yum, yeah.
So what you're saying here, right? So this installation required. So basically, for Nagios, you need a LAMP stack, Linux, Apache, MySQL, PHP.
Right.
And all of their dependency packages.
Yeah. This is first of all, this is a complete pure machine. You didn't, first of all, you first step, you just installed as a minimal virtual machine. There is nothing, I just install any package. Okay. So you just first, I'm just going to install the first package. Yum install minus hyphen y. Yum is the installation for all the packages installed for installing process. Yes for yes. There is nothing asking any questions. Httpd, it is a Apache services and PHP. What are the PHP is all the dependency is associated with it. It will install all it. Got it?
But one thing, what role, I mean, PHP, what exactly do we need?
Okay.
I know that Apache is required for
You have, yes. Web server, you see when some graphical interfaces, GUI is open up. So, okay. Through which web service is important for. Through, if you not install this package, the web service is not enabled over there.
GUI will not work properly.
Yeah, absolutely right.
I have done installation of Nagios before, but I did not know why we are using PHP.
Okay. And later on, I will show you how can you check the HTTPD. D is for daemon. Okay, that is defined as daemon services. HTTP, we know, okay, it is a service name. Whenever service name associated with the last word D, that means it is a daemon service. Daemon means, what do you mean by daemon? Daemon is a service which is running continuously when your virtual machine is up. Okay, any virtual machine is up, there you don't need any type of restart any services. That's why D is over here. Okay.
Yeah, got it.
Yeah. Second is creating Nagios user and group. And you see, if you don't know how to create any user in Linux group, I have a different separate video documents. I will share it. So user add simple. It's a command through which we can add any user in Linux. And group add is also if you want to create any new group. So let an example, if you want to user add, okay. So it will, here you see, user add. So new user is created. And if you want to see where is new user is created, so slash user slash etc slash password, where just tail run that command. So you can easily found out, okay, my new user has been created over there. Okay. The next step is user mode hyphen G, and this is the NAG CMD Nagios. What is this? User add hyphen G is if you adding a particular group, okay, into this. So G is associated, hyphen G is associated with your group. If you want to add a new user into a particular group, so you have to fire this particular command, okay. And there is a difference between capital G and a small g. Small g is associated with a GID. Okay, GID. That GID means is a numeric string. In a Linux, every user, every text has it's a numeric integration value. So through which we can define it. Okay. After executing these two commands, we have to create a new directory, mkdir. What do you mean by mkdir? That is a command, make directory. If you want to create any new directory, you have to create make directory. What is the sign of this? This sign indicate your home directory. if you see, how can you check where you were? So PWD, PWD, present working directory, through which you can easily find out, okay, my present working directory is this. So this title sign and slash forward slash is just went to the particular where you were. This is the prerequisite things you have to done before download Nagios package, core package and Nagios plugin. So here I'm going to download, already downloaded, and this is a process where we install your Nagios core and Nagios plugin. Okay, wget it is a basically a command which is download your package through the website. If you have any package which is associated in a web browser, in a website, if you want to download that package, you just right click it and just link, just select particular link and fire, just paste like this. Here, this is my new virtual machine. When I fire this command, you see command not found. That means your this virtual machine does not have wget package. Thereafter, what I did, just I install yum install wget. After installing it, the new package is searching and installing it. Okay. So this is a particular site, HTTP, this is the particular size, and the Nagios core dot tar dot z, that is a Nagios core package which is in the tar format. So when we execute wget and use this whole URL, after executing this, my whole package is downloading to the corresponding my present working directory. Okay, my present directory where I am, I'm where in root slash localhost Nagios. This is the where my whole package is downloading. Okay, so there is some links over here. There are some sources of sites where you can easily find out. Okay, this is, you see, this is a particular site. When you search this particular site, you can easily find out this particular package. Okay, now I have to download the Nagios plugin. Okay, so the same thing I have to execute wget and fire this particular command. These are the website. These are the officially website where you can download new packages and new plugins. So over here, this is the third party website where the all new packages are installed over here. But you can easily download through the main through the Nagios site even. And now, and after downloading of both the Nagios core and its plugin, so how we extract, because all these packages are in the tar format, so we need to extract these tar format into the actual format, because it is a compressed form. So tar-xvf, it is forcefully v for verbose, x for extracting. Okay, so I am just extracting the both the packages over here. So tar hyphen x, x for extracting, v for verbose, and f for force. It is extracting over here. You see, the plugins are also extracting over here. So ls minus l, it's a listing. The present working directory, if you want to see what are the package you list, so you can easily see over here, there is a tar format, that is a compressed format, that is a collection of all the files which is present into this Nagios directory, and the plugins also placed in this directory. Okay, now I have both Nagios core and its plugin I have placed in a defined directory. Now I have to see, okay, just cd Nagios. You can see easily, see, okay, these are the collection of files which is are important, and through this. So what I'm just enter into this directory and fire slash this sign is used for the executing of any of command. If you want to execute the installation, you see there is a one installation file installed at sh, but what is did? It is directly just if I fire this command like /forward, it is installing your package which is present into the current folder. So you see, when I just fire this command, there are some error is coming up. Why some error is coming? Because this is my virtual, this is my new virtual machine. So there is nothing as such new packages installed. And when because it cites new virtual minimal CentOS machine, its size about to be 700 MB. But if you download the whole Linux operating system like CentOS 7 GUI, so its size about 2 GB or 3 GB, more than 2 GB, because it is collecting all the packages. So when I am executing this command, so I am getting some error because our the installation of this file installation of these files, we need some dependent tools. So I need to install this. So I need to install this dependent tools, which is important for the executing of your packages. So after fire this command, yum group install development tools, and after completing, you need to yum update. Yum update is command which is completion. It is required your what are the dependency, what are the packages needs to be fixed. So, because sometimes what when you executing any commands, any fire any commands, you see some error is coming up. So you need to fix. So yum update just fixing your dependency and update your all the packages which is present in your Linux machines. So see, after running this command over here, you see the whole the execution is checking all the files and completion processes going on. Okay, after you need you see some of the binaries packages, some of the libraries needs to be installed. So after completion this, we need to install some files. So how can we? So mac install make all and make install, these are the two commands we need to fire. Okay, so in here, over here, so make install, I'm installing all the files. And these are the two commands you have to install, make install and make all. Because it's installing your packages and binaries packages which is present in your the Nagios files. And that now the after completion of the things, you need to install, fire this command, make install int, make install command mode, make install config. This command is configuration. Make install, what is the meaning of this command? It simply means installing your binary packages which is present in your Nagios folder. So init, command mode and config. These commands are very important. So step by step you need to follow this. So if I make install it, this is the init script which is already present in your Nagios folder, it will install it. So here see, init script installed. After command mode, after completing, then the same thing is display like this. Okay, for make install web form, web configuration, it is the configuration which is present in your web interface like an Apache services, because some of the services which is very important to reflecting on GUI on your dashboard. So you need to install this make install web form. Make install the simple installation process. What are the web configuration? The configuration part of the web services which is present in your folder. So after installing this bank install in, you need to check check your basically the password. This is HTTP password. This is basically your Apache password and like in web service password. So it will ask, so you need to install over here. So when you execute this command over here, it will ask your password. You can choose any password wherever you have wants. I'm just choosing my name over here. So just it. So after installing, we need to see systemctl start setpd. What is systemctl? It is used for start, and it is a command which is used for the starting to start any services which is present. Setpd is a Apache services. So D is for daemon and dot is a service. It is service. So sometimes when you start the server, it's showing some errors. So you need to check whether your firewall is enabling these services or not. So there is some firewall services command, like an example, systemctl firewall d, status firewall d. That is a command name through which you can see your firewall is running. Because what happens when you restart or start any service, sometimes your firewall block all the services. So we need to check every time is there any firewall is stopping your services or not. So over here, I am just installed my whole Nagios package till now. Now I need to install my Nagios plugins installation. So I will go to the same, back to the same directory where my Nagios plugin 2.2.1 I had been extracted over there. So I will just go to the that folder Nagios and doing the same, fire the same command. And fire this same command, that is a configuration your part which is present in this directory. And after executing this, I have to install. You can here make install or make all. You can use anything over here. So I am using make and make install over here. I'm just after make, it will compiling all your binaries which is present in the directory. It is a compilation process is over going over here. See, make install. After installation, we need to verify your configuration file. See, this is a predefined Nagios file which is present over here, through which we can through fire this command, we can easily check it whether my installation process is in a right way or not. If this is a very important command through which you can easily find out while executing this command, if you see any type of error, that means you did some mistakes. You had did some mistake over your compilation if you're while executing any command. So this is the final, this is a very important command for the configuration part, because this is the configuration file which gives the idea about how many mistakes if you did. Here, you see, when you're running over CAN, it will check your services, host, group, contact, everything it will find out. If total warning, total error. If it will show like an example of 3 warning or 2 error, that means you did some mistakes over there, yeah, 2 error, their mistake, 2 errors you did. So every time after installation of both the things, Nagios core as well as Nagios plugin, you have to fire this command and check it out. Okay, where I did mistake somewhere else. So you need to re-verify your step-by-step process. The command, you need to fire history command through which you can easily find out, okay, these are the commands I had fired. Okay, tell me.
Yes, but how to troubleshoot if you will get any issue or one?
Okay, I will tell you. What happened? Sometimes what happened, if you fire any command, if you see, like an example, I had been installing this document, I have facing some new issues. I will share you. Like when I restart my Apache service, I am showing some error. Okay, so you need to check whether your firewall system firewall status is running or not. Okay, So you have what I did, you just either you just allow that particular port over here, you have to just stop the firewall. This is the first error I have faced. You see over before I showed you some deployment. When I installing some, wait a second. Okay, so while I running any this executing command, I am facing some error. So I am getting some error. So after I am searching on the internet why this is particular error is coming up. So I found out some deployment tools is not missing. So what are the errors you are facing over here? You have to read, because when you read every error you can easily find out, because every
yes. So apart from Apache service, how many type of errors?
How many types of error you need to check? Your first, your firewall is allow, your firewall is stopping or not, your is there any some packages, yeah, dependency is had been missed by you, and yeah, and some library, yeah, there are sometimes you see while you installing any PHP, any library package, you are not, that package is not completed, so that can be you showing some types of errors while executing any commands,
sometimes version mismatch also there.
Right. So that's why I'm saying this is a very important. Wait, the configuration part. This, through which and after installing both things, your Nagios core and Nagios plugins, if you executing, how many mistakes, how many errors, it will define you. Okay. It will easily
if I will be getting any error, then the same error can be displayed over here, or
not error in here. You can easily find out you will find out you have two errors, and this command is just telling about the how many configuration issues you had created. This is nothing, just give the example of any services stopping and anything. It just this command is tells about the configuration issues. If you did any type of configuration issues, if you see any type of mistakes, any type of configuration
see, here,
parts.
Here I can get only like 2 errors, 3 errors, 4 errors, like that. But how to check this error? What errors, how I will find out what type of errors, and where I will find out?
Because वो ये पूछ रहा है कि जब ये कमांड चलाएगा तो जीरो एरर जीरो वार्निंग दिखाएगा, इसका मतलब कोई एरर नहीं है. अगर यहाँ पे बाई चांस 2 एरर दिखाया तो क्या वो एरर की डिटेल बताता है? क्या वो बताता है कि ये पॉइंट्स है जहाँ पे एरर थी?
After executing this command, you will find the configuration issues, or in total you will find out over here. So it will tells us, okay, you have missed this thing, you have missed this thing. I don't have any type, because if you install a step by step process in a fresh virtual machine, you will never find out any type of mistakes over here. So what type of new issues I already compiled in the document. So you will not find out any type of error or anything else if you execute as per the document, as per the document, because you see maximum times this command will not execute in your fresh virtual machine if you not install this package development tools. This is very important tool. If you missed this development tool, you will definitely find some errors. You will not, first of all, you will not execute this command. Make install here, make all. Okay. So here you see there is nothing as such error is coming up, and the total warning, that means you have executed all the commands in a perfect way. There is nothing as such you have been skipped. So now the fix is that is a negative services. Okay, so check config add negios, that means checking configuration, and I'm just executing this over here, the can configuration 35 on, and after executing this command sometimes it you need to start your negios services. Okay, so system CTL, it is used for the start any services, start the negios dot services. So after this compilation, you in a virtual machine, in your VMware, in a virtual machine, you just hit this IP. What is this IP? You see. This is my first virtual machine. I have enabled my networking. Okay, so when I just execute fire this command, you can go fire IPA, IP address too. If you find IPA, so you can easily find out your IP address. So IP address is 192.168.1.5. So sometimes there is some issues with your VMware. So you need to ping your this IP through CMD, whether the communication is channel is connected or not. So what you have to do, the next step, you just the IP address which I shown over there. So the IP address and the negios / negios. So when you enter on the web your browser, so you need to ask the password, username, the password. So you see, you will, when you execute this type of display, you will show it. So negios core is a open source, is a free. You didn't need to pay any type of single payment. After executing, you need to this is only the installation part, but it is free. That's why it is so much complex, because there are the so many hosts, so many devices. So you need to just go into the configuration part and just add over there. So this is a GUI. Here you see negios xi log servers. This is paid version, so we will not go for the paid version, we are just going for the free version. So over here you see host services group. So when you click over here in host, so what type of host you have added, so the configuration part of host is not going into the directly over here, you need to configuration in the CLI mode. So over here, this is the another type of error I was facing, because my firewall D, it is the services is running, that why it is stopping my all other services. Because if you want to enable any service in Linux, you need to allow that service in firewall. So what I did, I just stopped this firewall and restart my negios services, and sometimes and start my Apache services. You can start systemctl stpd, start stpd. If you execute both the commands, so you can easily see this thing on the web browser. That's it.
If you, see, you mean we cannot add the network element over here in
front end? No, you can add.
No, you cannot. You cannot because we need to just go to the CLI and to the over here and the configuration host file, services files.